my stories. And in the same way that we must replace photographs and furniture after a fire, I had to gather new stories and put them in my mouth and roll them with my tongue. After so many hours of running, running like a river stretching out toward the sea, a long line of turtles, one in front of the other, the same way I force my feet one in front of the other, not moving fast enough to escape the perilous fire, but by God's grace, escaping one foot in front of the other. Running, 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 one foot in front of the other, not knowing how to get where I didn't know I was going. Running in slow motion, as if in a nightmare, my feet crumbling under me. And all at once, I woke up on October the 8th, and sugar was falling from the sky. I tried to catch it, but it melted at my touch. My children caught it in their mouths, and it disappeared on their tongues. It covered the ground, and I didn't know how to walk. My legs were slipping from under me, but here, there was no perilous fire waiting to catch me. Here was a peaceful place where sugar fell from the sky. So I got up and walked slowly, no more running, simply one foot in front of the other. I took new photographs, I bought new furniture. I tell the story of the sugar sky, reminding me, the queen, me, the mother, that all I must do is remember to put one foot in front of the other.